Hello everyone and welcome to this talk. My name is Andres Perez Lopez and I am going to present our work PapaFill, a low complexity sound even localization and detection method with parametric particle filter and gradient boosting. We will start introducing the problem and describing our proposed methodology. We will then comment on the experimental setup and discuss the obtained results. Finally, we will close with the main conclusions of the work. Sound even localization and detection refers to the problem of identifying for each individual event present in a sound field, the spatial location, temporal activity, and sound class to which it belongs. The case 2019 featured for the first time a challenge task on sound even localization and detection. This challenge was an important milestone of the problem since it helped to develop a large number of works, most of which outperform a recently proposed baseline system. Among all these methods, there is a clear predominance of convolutional neural networks, which mainly approach the problem either in a first classification then localization approach or by means of joint or ensemble methods. However, there has been a small group of systems which follow a different approach, better described as first localization then classification. This type of methods usually make use of parametric spatial audio analysis. It is important to mention that such structure allows them to disambiguate the situation when two sound sources belonging to the same sound class are active simultaneously. Such case is usually not solvable by the converse approach. The presented work continues the exploration of parametric-based localization and detection methods, focusing on a low complexity architecture that makes use of traditional machine learning and feature-based approaches. The proposed method receives the name of PapaFill, which stands for Parametric Particle Filter. This system has been presented to the DKS Challenge 2020, and the open source implementation can be found at the provided link. PapaFill is based on four main building blocks. First, a single source time frequency regions of the input ambisonic signal are found and localized using a parametric spatial model. The extracted data is fed into a particle tracking system, which estimates two of the three required informations, sound even trajectories and temporal activations. In parallel, the input signal is partially filtered by beamforming using the computed localization. Finally, the resulting signal is assigned a label by the classifier, thus obtaining the remaining information. The first block performs the single source estimation. The main assumption here is the fact that sound sources are sparse in the time frequency domain. Therefore, it may be possible to find spectral regions which contain significant energetic contribution from only one source, and these regions can provide accurate direction of arrival or DOA estimates. In the literature, single source regions are typically obtained by two main methods, by analyzing the sound field diffuseness or by subspace methods. The latter can provide better results, but at the expense of local estimation of eigenvalues, which is a computationally expensive procedure. Keeping in mind the target low complexity, we opt for the former method. In our work, diffuseness is computed using the Dirac definition from the input ambisonic signal. The single source test is reduced to binary masking with a fixed threshold. Finally, instantaneous narrowband DOA estimates are computed by the angle of the intensity vector. In this spectrogram, we can observe the output of the single source estimation method. The horizontal axis depicts time in seconds, while the vertical axis represents frequency. The different colors are mapped to the estimated DOA of the given time frequency bin. White spaces represent the regions where less or more than one source are present. Once a set of reliable DOA estimates is obtained, the next step is the generalization of the individual measurements into trajectories and temporal activations. For that, we employ the raw Blackwellized Monte Carlo Data Association Algorithm, or RBMCDA. This algorithm is a kind of Kalman filter or tracker and has a big number of parameters, including priors of angular velocity, event birth and noise percentage, statistics of the measurement noise, number of Monte Carlo trials, among others. For the method inputs, we compute the instantaneous wideband median values of the DOAs. The output is a list of objects with spatiotemporal trajectories. A last post-processing step is required in order to remove spurious objects and interpolate trajectories for adjusting to the target spatiotemporal resolution. This image represents the whole process on this, of the single source estimation on top and the particle filter on the bottom. The spectrogram on the top is the same as before. The plot on the bottom represents time versus position. In that sense, different colors in the top plot represent different vertical positions in the top, in the bottom figure. For each time frame in the top spectrogram, a single point is computed through the median and represented with a blue cross. All individual points are fed into the particle filtering, and the output is the set of contiguous green lines, each representing a different trajectory of a sound event. The DOA is also used for the spatial filter of the signal. In that way, we are able to improve the signal-to-noise ratio of the target sound event. Since we have obtained the temporal activities as well, we can further segment the resulting waveform audio. As a result, we obtain single-channel segmented estimations of the sound events, which will be used to fit the classifier. The spatial filter has been implemented here as a maximum directivity beamformer in the spherical harmonic domain. Regarding the classifier, we have opted for a classical machine learning approach. The main advantages for such approach are the low complexional requirements needed, which also speed the algorithm iterative development time. As a side consequence, the importance of the parameters is available, which might help to make the whole process more understandable. This motivates the election of gradient boosting machine as the classification method. The algorithm is aimed to minimize the loss of the objective function by adding many weak learners. These learners are typically simple decision trees and their parameters are tuned using gradient descent techniques. Some features are obtained using the library Essentia. We have used both low-level features such as Mel bands, MFCCs, and spectral features, and more abstract dimensions such as harmonic and envelopes. Some of the features are applied to the whole audio signal, while others are frame-based. In the latter case, we use the mean and variance of cross time. The dataset used is the first order ambisonic version of the Tau-Niggens Spatial Sound Events 2020. It contains 600,000 scenes of 60 seconds of duration each. The sound scenes contain sound events belonging to one of 14 different classes, and they are taken from the Niggens dataset. Sound events might be either static or move in circles at fixed angular velocities. Furthermore, all events have been convolved with recorded room impulse responses. There is a maximum of two simultaneously overlapped sound events. And finally, apart from the added reverberation, there's a moderate amount of added background noises in the scenes. The baseline method is based on the recently proposed CELTNET architecture, which features a convolutional recurrent neural network that solves both localization and classification problems jointly. Additionally, the baseline implementation have been improved with several changes, in part by one of the best performing methods in the case 2019 Task 3 challenge. Since our classifier input are single channel, temporally segmented sound event estimates, we must preprocess the given training dataset in order to adapt it to our needs. We have explored two different approaches regarding the data generation. The first approach, named PapaFill1, uses the Oracle information about localization and temporal activity by parsing the annotation files. Conversely, PapaFill2 approach uses the actual parametric filter system and implements a custom event class association for the labeling. The consequence is that PapaFill1 has more accurate training data available, but such data is less similar than the actual data that we'll be using during the evaluation compared with PapaFill2. This situation also leads to two different Oracle systems, denoted with a final O, that will be used for performance comparison. The graphic here shows the different amount of sound events of each class after the dataset processing for both approaches. Although the total amount of events is similar, we can observe some sound classes with significant differences. For instance, the dog class has almost twice samples in PapaFill1, while the inverse situation happens for fire, footsteps, and engine sound classes. Such differences might be explained by different criteria applied for the consideration of event temporal activations. The accurate event segmentation in PopAffiL 1 has suggested the necessity for data augmentation techniques. Specifically, we have implemented pitch shifting, time shifting, time stretching, and white noise addition. Furthermore, given the good results obtained in other fields, we have implemented for the first time in localization and detection problems a reverberant data augmentation technique. Synthetic room impulse responses with varying reverberation times have been randomly created and mixed with the event estimates. This table shows some of the values for some of the most relevant parameters used in our system. A deeper insight on this topic is provided in the paper. To close this section, we will refer to the evaluation metrics which are proposed by the challenge organization. The main idea here is to measure the performance in a joint manner by using some recently defined metrics. More specifically, we are measuring localization and classification separately, but depending on the results of the other task. Two metrics refer to the location-aware classification, error rate and F-score. They only count if localization error is below 20 degrees. Similarly, localization error and localization recall are only taken into account if the estimated class matches. The SELD metric is used as an overall metric and consists of a weighted average of all other metrics. This table summarizes the results for our two proposed methods compared with the baseline. The results for the Oracle methods are shown at the bottom part of the table. The best results for each metric are highlighted. The first remarkable result is the good performance in three out of the four metrics, error rate, F-score, and localization error, where both proposed methods outperform the baseline system. This result is reflected in the SEL score, where again both proposed approaches outperform the baseline system. Regarding the Oracle methods, the results fall into the expected ranges. Oracle 1 has almost a perfect localization, but the classification errors influence the localization results. In turn, the Oracle 2 methods perform better in all other metrics. The good results of this setup allows validation of the parametric filter approach and leaves space for and indicates for further improvements. The performance of the proposed method deteriorates noticeably with overlapping sounds, mainly due to the low performance of the diffuseness estimator in such cases, which is a known issue. The research suggests the need for more sophisticated source detection and counting methods. To conclude, the figure shows the relative importance of the classifier parameters in the GBM for PopAffiL 2. It is clear that the most important features relate to the temporal duration of the estimated events. This might explain the outperformance of PopAffiL 2 over PopAffiL 1, since in the former case, event durations match better with the evaluation setup. It is also important to highlight the great relevance of low-level parameters and especially MFCCs on the classification task. In conclusion, we have presented a low-complexity method for sound event localization and detection of first-order ambisonic signals. The method localizes first sound events using a parametric particle filter approach and then classifies the estimated events with a gradient boosting machine. The results outperform a baseline state-of-the-art convolutional recurrent neural network. For future work, there are a number of topics that could be investigated. Improving single-source detection, refine the particle filter parameters, maybe using some sort of automatic optimization, or reduce the dependency on duration, to name a few. Thank you very much for your attention.